Hey everyone, welcome to this week's new video at this Dingley Dutch Countryside. Today we're going to be talking about one of my favorite provinces in the Netherlands, and it's called Gelderland. Gelderland is mainly known for its really beautiful nature. There are trees everywhere, it houses two of the biggest national parks and most famous parks in the Netherlands, and it's definitely worth a visit. So yeah, don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe with the little notification bell so you won't miss any of my other upcoming videos. And let's head into the video. For those who are new here, my name is Manon and I am Dutch. And at visiting the Dutch countryside, you will be discovering the Netherlands beyond the crowds with a local, which is obviously me. So yeah, the province of Gelderland is the biggest province in the Netherlands and it's found mainly in the center and a bit in the east of the Netherlands. Although it's the biggest province in the Netherlands, that's only when it comes to the surface of land, because if you include the surface of water, then the province of Friesland, which is up in the north, is the biggest province. But yeah, when it comes to land, Gelderland is the biggest province. You can find a travel guide for the province of Friesland right here, which you can check out later or now, whatever you want. The capital city of Gelderland is the city of Arnhem, and it's not the biggest city actually. It's the biggest city is Nijmegen, which is also famous for the 4 Days March. If you know that, then you know it, and otherwise I will tell you more about it by the end of this video, something like that. But the biggest municipality is Apeldoorn. So Gelderland used to belong to the Duchy of the Duchy. I still don't know how to pronounce it. Is it Duchy, Duchy, Duchy? Something like that. Belonged to the Duchy of Gelre from the 14th century until the end of the 18th century. The Duchy of Gelre, that basically the north of Limburg and the current area of Gelderland belongs to Gelre. It also had a part of the German state, Nordrhein-Westfalen. That's how we pronounce it in Dutch, but yeah. So it was pretty big. It's really interesting because Gelderland is really famous for its nature, like I already said. But there are just some different areas when it comes to that. So then you have, for instance, the Achterhoek, which is the ultimate countryside, but also it has some hills and some beautiful trails, hiking trails, and it's stunning. And then at the Veluwe you have moorlands or heather fields, however you want to call them. You have little creeks, you have sand, drifts, forests, yeah. And then you also have some of the biggest rivers floating through Gelderland. So that makes a completely different area as well. So you've got the Meuse River, which divides the provinces of Noord-Brabant. You'll find a travel guide for Noord-Brabant here. The Meuse River divides the province of Noord-Brabant and Gelderland. Then you also have the Waal River and the Rijn River. And you also have the IJssel River. So not only can you find a lot of, you know, big rivers here, which creates for a beautiful environment, but also the smaller nature reserves, beautiful long meadows, lots of forest, beautiful fields with heather or with wildflowers, long trees, you know. Gelderland basically has everything that you can wish for when it comes to nature. Well, except for beaches. Although on the side of the river, they usually have some really cool river beaches. If you're planning on swimming in the river, then you really need to be careful because the current is really strong. So there's, usually people are only going until the middle of their body. So if you go too far in, just trust me, you do not want to do that. So yeah, every year people die because they go too far into the river, they are drowned because of the currents, they cannot swim against it, stuff like that. So rivers are beautiful. If you want to swim in them, be very careful. The highest point in the province of Gelderland can be found on the Veluwe. So the Veluwe region, it's around 110 meters high, and it's called Signaal in Bosch. Gelderland is known for quite some famous Dutch people, such as Daphne Schippers, you know, the sprinting champion. She's from the province of Gelderland. There are tons of people that are from there, because obviously it's the biggest province when it comes to land surface. So I've already mentioned cities such as Nijmegen, Arnhem and Apeldoorn, but mainly because, you know, Nijmegen is the biggest city and Arnhem is its capital and Apeldoorn is the biggest municipality, but they are also really, really good to visit. Nijmegen has oldest shopping street in the Netherlands, but that's not all that Nijmegen has to offer. Nijmegen is one of those cities that I didn't expect to like, but then it just completely won me over. It's a beautiful city, friendly people, you have those cozy cafes, you have really, really old, typical Dutch brown bars. It just has this nice and welcoming atmosphere. What I also like about Nijmegen is that it's located on the Waal River. So they basically created a bit of a city beach in one of the branches of the river, basically. And you are allowed to swim there. And the current is less strong because those big ships are not allowed to sail through there, but through another channel. And then you have the city of Arnhem. The city of Arnhem is really, really, really green. And I love it. Arnhem has this more of a modern vibe than Nijmegen, but not too modern. I don't know, it has something special. And I don't know if it's all the nature reserves that are basically in and outside the city, or that it's the people, or I don't know. If you are in the area of Arnhem or Nijmegen, visit. Gelderland is not only good to visit when you're looking for big cities to visit, because in fact, the smallest cities and towns and villages are what makes it Gelderland. It just adds the atmosphere and the vibe and something special to its entire region. So for instance, you have cities such as Zutphen, Elburg and Harderwijk. But then you also have smaller towns and villages like Buren, Bronckhorst. It's just so beautiful and I would say idyllic, but it's such an overrated word, but it's really filled with those old medieval streets, those beautiful historic buildings, really interesting museums, beautiful surroundings. Those kind of towns are what you're looking for when you're visiting the Netherlands. I've already talked a little bit about museums, but not a lot. But the province of Gelderland is filled. And with filled, I mean absolutely stuffed with amazing museums. Honestly. It's overflowing. You've got Paleis het Loo or the Royal Palace het Loo, and you have those beautiful palace gardens. Then you also have het Nederlands Openluchtmuseum, which is the most visited museum in the Netherlands outside of museums in Amsterdam. And it's the open air museum, the Netherlands Open Air Museum. You're going back in time, you will see typical crafts, beautiful small buildings. There's even a candy store with old Dutch candies. There's so much to explore there. If you want to get a taste of what the Netherlands has looked like in the past, then visiting the Netherlands Open Air Museum is one of the best things that you can do in the Netherlands. You also have the Kröller-Müller Museum in Otterlo, which is really famous for having one of the biggest Vincent van Gogh collections in the world, besides the Vincent van Gogh Museum. So, yeah, it has a lot. But there are also smaller museums, such as about World War II, mainly in the city of Arnhem and in its surroundings, but there are so many smaller and really good museums as well. I will list some of the great museums that you can visit in the province of Gelderland below, because naming them all is going to take me a long time, and I don't believe that you have the patience to listen to that, and I probably don't have the patience to list them all. So yeah, I will settle for that. So then we're going to national parks. The Hoge Veluwe is the first national park that I will be talking about. The Hoge Veluwe is actually the biggest lowland terrain nature reserve in northwestern Europe, and it spans around 5,400 hectares, which is, I don't know how many acres, but it's big for Dutch standards, it's really, really big. It is also a national park that you need to pay a fee to enter. And it is also the most touristic national park in the Netherlands. The problem with that is that most people go to standard areas inside a national park. So it gets really, really busy at some certain places, which is not something that you want in a national park because animals need their space, plants need to grow, you know, they need to flourish, everything needs to work together. But when there are coming too many people, when they are mountain biking through areas where birds need to rest, or where deers or swines need to rest, that's just not okay. So if you want to visit, that's fine, visit De Hoge Veluwe, but search some of the places that not many people go to. Just, you can ask people to them, or by the time this video is out I will probably have a Hoge Veluwe guide written down for you, so it's probably in the bio below. But yeah, please, 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 please do not disturb nature. Leave nature as much as it can be, because we want to experience it, but other generations also need to experience it. Also, if you see anyone feeding a wild deer or a wild, you know, boar, those swines, please, please tell them to stop it right away, because those animals are the first ones to get killed, because they will get shot because they come close to humans, they will get shot because they are running over roads, and they will attack cars, they will basically, and they will run to humans because they think every human has food for them. And those animals are really dangerous actually. They can go from 0 to 60 kilometers per hour within a finger snap if they feel threatened. So if you see anyone feeding animals, really, really tell them to stop it right now, because it's dangerous for the animal. So okay, my rant is done, but yeah, keep that in mind. Then you also have National Park de Veluwe Zone, which is around 5,100 hectares. This national park is free to visit, and it is filled with incredible walking routes along heather fields, through beautiful forests, you know, it has everything also that you can wish for. So, and it's a lot less crowded than at the Veluwe, so yeah, you know, choose whatever you want, but I prefer less people. So the province of Gelderland is also filled with a lot of cool activities and festivals and events, but one of the highlights is the Nijmeegse Vierdaagse, or the 4-day marches in Nijmegen. It's basically 4 days of people walking in the area of Nijmegen. I believe around 40,000 people are allowed to join. I will put down how many people are allowed to join, because I forgot. I wrote a guide about these 4-day marches. You can find it down in the description of this video. But I kind of forgot how many people. It's a lot. So the distances range from around 30 or 35 kilometers to 50. So it's a really, really cool event, and so many people want to join every single year, which is not possible. So yeah, you need to be lucky to enter and to be able to walk these 4 days. Not everyone completes the 4 days because it's really, really difficult. Yeah, and it's a lot. So you start early in the morning at around 5 or earlier, depending on how warm it is. And then you need to be finished before a certain time. You need to cross the finish, and then you are allowed to go on to the next day. Lots of people get blisters, people get dehydrated, but besides that, it's really fun. So the Nijmeegse Vierdaagse obviously takes place in the city of Nijmegen. Basically starts and finishes there. During that walk, you will go through many beautiful areas in Nijmegen and its surroundings, and it is one big party during. Well, it starts before the event already, but yeah. So let's say it's around a week that you can go partying in Nijmegen. Really, really good, even better than normally. So you will love it if you like to party and if you like food. So yeah guys, that was it for this week's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you learned something about the province of Gelderland, and that you are now thinking of visiting it. You won't regret it. I will place a link to some of the beautiful places that I've listed in this video below in the description box, so you can check them out. I would recommend you to do so. So yeah, that was it. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe with the little notification bell so you won't miss any of my other upcoming videos, because you don't want to. So yeah, I will see you next week.